There is a place for the sadness. Hold on to love. There is a season of gladness. Hold on to love. When pain and confusion seems endless. Hold on to love. We cultivate healing through kindness. Hold on to love where hope is found. Hold on to love where joy abounds. Hold on to love where grace and mercy is overflowing. Hold on to love. Hold on to love. Terror and fear overwhelm us. Hold on to love. Our courage and faith will sustain us. Hold on to love. When violence seeks to destroy us. Hold on to love. Our acts of compassion. Hold on to love. Hold on to love where hope is found. Hold on to love where joy abounds. Hold on to love where grace and mercy is overflowing. Hold on to love. Hatred is used to divide us. Hold on to love. Wisdom and truth reunite us. Hold on to love. When prejudice poses as freedom. Hold on to love. Dignity means all are welcome. Hold on to love. Hold on to love where hope is found. Hold on to love where joy abounds. Hold on to love where grace and mercy is overflowing.
Welcome to this celebration of the Eucharist for the 13th Sunday in Ordinary Time from St. Patrick's Parish in Anchorage, Alaska. Our presider today is Father Leo Walsh, assisted by Deacon Mick Fornelli. This Mass is being offered for the repose of the soul of Drew Koop. Our opening hymn is All Are Welcome. Permission to podcast stream the music in our services has been obtained from one license, with license A-717186, all rights reserved. God bless you, and thank you for joining us today.
One, two, three, four.
Let us build a house where love can dwell.
And
saved, all can safely live. A place where saints and children tell how hearts learn to forgive. Built of hopes and dreams and visions, rock of faith and vault of grace. Here the love of Christ shall end divisions. All are welcome. Let us build a house where prophets speak
and words are strong and true, where all God's children dare to seek to dream God's reign anew. Here the cross shall stand as witness, as a symbol of God's grace.
Here as one we claim the faith of Jesus. All are welcome, all are welcome, all are welcome in His grace. Let us build a house where love is found in water, wine, and wheat. A banquet hall on holy ground, peace and justice meet. Hear the love of God through Jesus is revealed in time and space. As we share in Christ the feast that frees us, all are welcome.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Got it. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Great. Well, good evening, everybody, as we come, and welcome everybody in live stream land as we come here for the 13th Sunday. And we hear a lot, especially tonight, about hospitality and about compassion. That we might truly enter in these sacred mysteries. Let's call to mind our sins, for the Lord is full of mercy and compassion.
I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Great.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of the good. We praise you. Take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
That's for those of you that it's your first time here at the drive-up Mass, you honk when it's time for an amen. That's just the way. Could I have an amen? Always wanted to do that.
A reading from the second book of Kings. One day, Elisha came to Shunem, where there was a woman of influence who urged him to dine with her. Afterward, whenever he passed by, he used to stop there to dine. So she said to her husband, "I know that Elisha is a holy man of God. Since he visits us often, let us arrange a little room on the roof and furnish it for him with a bed, table, chair, and lamp, so that when he comes to us, he can stay there." Sometime later, Elisha arrived and stayed in the room overnight. Later, Elisha asked, "Can something be done for her?" His servant, Gehazi, answered, "Yes. She has no son, and her husband is getting on in years." Elisha said, "Call her." When the woman had been called and stood at the door, Elisha promised, "This time next year, you will be fondling a baby son." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Goodness of the Lord.
He shall know my faithful hand is there. He shall say of me, you are my Father, my Savior God, my Rock.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. And as to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Alleluia. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Let your heart rejoice in the Lord. Let your word proclaim his deeds. Let your voice sing out to the world that our God has come to save.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds his life will lose it. And whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Whoever receives you, receives me. And whoever receives me, receives the one who sent me. Whoever receives a prophet because he is a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. And whoever receives a righteous man because he is a righteous man will receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones to drink, because the little one is a disciple, amen, I say to you, he will surely not lose his reward. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It's nice not to be doing this in a thunderstorm for a change. It's good to be here. Welcome. Thank you for coming today. And it's neat to see. You can bring your lawn chair when the weather's nice. And as long as you stay 6 feet apart, we're okay. Feel free. A lot of fun. Also, a lot of things going on in the gospel and in the readings today. Let's talk about two of them, though. Hospitality and compassion. So get those two words into your mind. Hospitality and compassion. Let's talk about hospitality first, shall we? Now, hospitality can be fun. You might have heard about the family that is hosting a really large dinner party. And when all the guests arrive and they're all sat down, the mother asks the little girl to say grace. She says, "But Mommy, I don't know how to pray. I don't know what to say." And the mother says, "Well, you've heard me pray. Just say what you heard me say." So she very dutifully makes her hands in the prayer hands, and she makes the sign of the cross. And then she says, "Good Lord, what was I thinking when I invited all these people over from my house for dinner?" Now we have a great example. Hospitality here in the first reading, where the woman from Shunan who would welcome Elisha the prophet into her home on a regular basis. Now, prophets were seen as the mouthpiece of God, okay? So by welcoming God's prophet, she welcomes God's word into her home, and she doesn't go without a reward, as you see. Also, Christ exhorts us in the gospel, "Whoever receives you receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me." And he goes on to say to whoever receives a prophet, gosh, might be talking about the woman in the Shunan, or a righteous man will receive the reward that they would receive. So hospitality is important. In fact, it's one of the hallmarks of a good parish. People will come back to your parish for three reasons: good hospitality, good preaching, and good music. If you can hit two out of three of those, most people will come back. If you hit them all, they all will. So I've mentioned before about good hospitality. The very good definition of hospitality was by Anselme Brillant Savarin, who said, "To welcome the guest is to be answerable for his or her happiness so long as he is beneath your roof." To be responsible and answerable for his happiness so long as he is beneath your roof, or in your parking lot, as the case may be. You'll remember from a homily a few months ago that good hospitality is welcoming, friendly, and courteous. It's knowledgeable, it's efficient, it's flexible, it's consistent, it communicates effectively, and it exceeds expectations. So now might be a good time to ask ourselves, as individuals, as a parish, how are we doing in hospitality? In the midst of the pandemic, how have we engaged those in our neighborhood, our schools, our places of business, our local community? Remember back when Pope Francis was first installed as the Bishop of Rome? One of the things he said was we had to get out of our churches and into the streets. Well, guess what? We don't have any choice. That's what we've been doing. And so maybe the Holy Spirit, through whatever means. But how are we doing? Our schools, our places of business, our local community. While they may not have been able to be under our roof right now, have we emerged from underneath our roof to see to their needs? Good hospitality looks to the needs of the other, not just when it's convenient, but especially when it is not. And in this way,
is very closely related to our second theme, that of compassion. Now, it's an interesting word, compassion. It comes from the Latin, two words, cum, which means with, obviously, and, or maybe not obviously if you've never studied Latin, cum, which is with, or pa, and passio, which means to suffer. It's a deponent verb for those of you who are wondering. So, cum passio literally means to suffer with another. So to be compassionate is not just to be with someone who is suffering, but literally to suffer with them, to enter into that suffering. Paul, what does this mean then for the Christian? Paul speaks to the baptized in Rome about how by virtue of their own baptism, they are true participants in the passion, death, and resurrection of Christ. It's a kind of compassio, a kind of suffering with Christ. This is one of the this is one way of understanding what Christ meant in the gospel when he said to pick up your cross and follow me. The Christian shares in the Paschal mystery at the very level of their being, and as such, we can expect to suffer with him on behalf of others and with others, to die with him, and thus we do not go without our reward. We rise with him. But it doesn't end there, does it? The Christian is never saved in isolation. We're baptized in the mystical body of Christ, the church. And for us here in Muldoon, it takes the form of this fun-loving group of holy goofballs known as St. Patrick's Parish. We're not perfect, but we try to be faithful to God and to each other. We're saved as a people, as a parish family. When we build up one another, we build up the body of Christ. We suffer with one another. Sometimes we die to self in the midst of one another, and we rise again as a community of faith, as a parish family. But wait, there's more. As the church, as a parish, we don't just exist for ourselves. We're not a closed society. We never have been. We're a people of hospitality, but we exist then for the sanctification of the world, or if not the entire world, then certainly that little part of the world with which we're going to come into contact. Our job as a parish is to become so much a part of the surrounding community that they cannot imagine life without us. We are called, if you will, to be the light of Nunaka Valley or anywhere else you happen to be. Howard Street, it's a good place. By our baptism, we are consecrated as missionaries to our neighborhoods, our schools, our workplaces, our social circles. By simply living our faith and acting with charity, we'll till the soil around us so that the seeds of faith may take root in the lives of those around us, that they in turn may receive the word of God and enter into his grace. It's a supreme act of hospitality, if you will. So hospitality and compassion, the two are more related than you might think, aren't they? To wish the happiness of the other is to want what's best for them and to enter into their reality, to rejoice with those who rejoice, to weep with those who weep, to be salt and light in our homes, our neighborhoods, our community, our world. And if not the whole world, then certainly that part of the world with which we will come into contact this week.
I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary. Amen. For our sake and for our right under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. Will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Christ comes to us in our need. If we have died with him, we shall rise with him on the last day. With faith in God's compassion and God's mercy, let us come with our prayers and our petitions.
For Pope Francis, for our Bishop Andrew, and all bishops throughout the world, that they may continue to inspire and lead all people for a greater glory of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Spirit will inspire more individuals to accept a vocation to the priesthood, the diaconate, and religious life in our archdiocese and throughout the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all whose lives have been scarred by the violence of others, that men and women of vision will touch their lives with love and give them reason to love again, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those that serve in public office, that they never accept as normal poverty and discrimination in our land, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish family, and especially for those members who received their first communion this weekend, that they may live as children of light, and that we may all strive to follow the bright life of truth, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation, as we prepare to celebrate Independence Day, that we can be thankful and appreciate all who have given service to keep our country free as one nation under God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the military, our police, our firefighters, our medical professionals, and all first responders who put their lives on the line every day for our safety, that they may be protected from harm and return safely to their families, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful departed, resting in our cloister cemetery, for those individuals remembered on our memorial walls, and for all the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Out of mercy and compassion, hear our prayers. Answer them in accord with your will, if we ask them in the name of Jesus, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. I keep forgetting this part. Obviously the collection happens differently. Thank you for all of you who have used the online giving app. That's just magnificent. And thank you so much. That helps keep us going. If you want to learn how to do that, you simply go to our website, little green button up in the top says donate, and follow the directions right there. Also, thank you to all of you who have been mailing in your envelopes. That's just been a marvelous testimony of faith. If you're here today and you've got your envelopes, we actually have the little baskets right here. And if you end up coming in during the week, you're like, oh, I forgot. Don't worry. You can just drop it in the little deposit box over here. Thank you so much for supporting the ministry here at St. Patrick Parish. And God bless you for your generosity.
I am the bread of life. I am the hope in night. I am the door wide open. I am the shepherd's mind. I am the truth and life.
I am who am, and I am for you. Come and follow me. I am bread for the world, hope for the hopeless. Come to me and know that I'll always be there. With my arms open wide, I am who am, and I am for you. Come and follow me. The bread of
bread for the world.
I am the hope in
life. The hope
I am the door wide open
to me.
I am the shepherd. Those who are in need,
hope
for today and for tomorrow, a light for all who want to see. I am the bread of
life.
Shepherds
always be there.
I am the truth and life. I am the way of life. I am who am, and I am for you. Come and follow me. I am who am,
and I am for you. Come and follow me.
Friends, pray with me that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Amen. Well, God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death. And by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. With your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world,
Savior of the world,
for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
You have set us free.
You have set us free.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one Spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Patrick and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Andrew, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace in unity in accordance with your will. We live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Repeat. Yeah, see? Good. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Your spirit.
Thanks. Christ, for eternal life, for those of us who receive it.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
An act of spiritual communion for those who cannot receive today. As I cannot this day enjoy the happiness of assisting at the holy mysteries, O my God, I transport myself in spirit at the foot of your altar. I unite with the church, which by the hands of the priest offers to you your beloved Son in the holy sacrifice of the Mass. I offer myself with him, by him, and in his name. I adore, I praise, and I thank you, imploring your mercy, invoking your assistance, and presenting you the homage I owe you as my Creator, the love due to you as my Savior. Apply to my soul, I beseech you, O merciful Jesus, your infinite merits. Apply them also to those for whom I particularly wish to pray. I desire to communicate spiritually that your blood may purify me, your flesh strengthen me, and your spirit sanctify me. May I never forget that you, my divine Redeemer, has died for me. May I die to all that is not you, that hereafter I may live eternally with you. Amen.
Precious body, precious blood, seen as bread and wine. Hear the Lord prepares a feast divine. Bread of love is broken now, cup of life. Precious body, precious blood, seen as bread and wine. Here the Lord prepares the feast divine. Bread of love is broken now, cup of life is poured. Share the supper of the Lord. I am the living spring of eternal life. You that drink from me shall not thirst again. Body, precious blood, here in bread and wine. Here the Lord prepares the feast divine. Bread of love is broken now, cup of life is is the supper of the Lord. I am the bread of heaven, giving life to body, precious blood, here in bread and wine. Here the Lord prepares the feast divine. Bread of love is broken now, cup of life is share the supper of the
Lord. Let us pray. May this divine sacrament we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Great. Just a couple of quick announcements. Three, actually. 3.5. Okay, so the One Bread, One Body annual appeal, thank you so much. We're just in the first month of it, and already we are at almost 50% of our goal, just a little shy of it, as you can see in the little red thermometer in the bulletin. The goal is $76,244. Anything we raise over that amount comes right back to the parish for needed capital improvements, and to the church and to the parish grounds. So let's get that knocked out so we can start raising money for the parish. It all goes to very good things. Check out the bulletin this week especially about those parishes that are rural and don't get Mass every weekend, let alone maybe perhaps once a month when we can get a priest out there. 18 parishes of the 36, it's 18 parishes of the 26 actually share a priest with another parish. Responsible reopening, what's going on? Our protocols for gatherings other than liturgical celebrations have been approved. So this allows limited meetings of various groups within the parish. Contact the parish office for details on how to develop your mitigation and safety plan. These need to be approved before your group can advertise their meeting and before they can meet physically. And you fill out the worksheet. It's pretty simple. Kind of runs you through everything you need to know. Tomorrow, the rites of initiation will be celebrated for our 6 catechumens and 4 candidates at the 10 a.m. live stream Mass. So if you want to get in on that, it'll be a little longer, but it'll be really, really worth it. They've been waiting since Easter to be baptized. Pretty cool. So if you want to share in that, by all means, and keep them in prayer too. And especially a big shout out to Ted and Gina Kaiser, the second grade catechists whose guidance and care for our young people led a beautiful celebration of First Communion today. All the parents gave permission so you can check it, so we can post it, so you can check it out on our Facebook page. It was a lot of fun. So, and thanks to John and Rima who sanitized the church after that and after the wedding today. So yeah. It was really appreciated. So you can get a lot of work out of a deacon candidate, man. The Lord be with you. Oh, I'm sorry. And instructions for those of you who haven't been to the Drive Up Mass before, for communion, we'll have the 3 stations right here immediately following Mass as we go and take off our vestments and sanitize, and then we'll come up. We ask you to come up with a mask if you can. Give yourself 6 feet between the person in front of you that's not from your household, and we'll be at the various stations. If you can, please receive in the hand, move 6 feet away, and then lower your mask and receive, and then free to leave after your prayer of thanksgiving. So thanks so much to everybody, especially Ed, who's pretty much been here all day, as everybody else, because they were doing music at the First Communion Mass today too and setting up. And John behind the camera, and everybody that's, and Brendan, everyone who's helped make things. And Deacon Mick, because he's nice to have around too. Yeah. You can get a lot of work out of a deacon. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed be the Lord, blessed be the Lord, the God of mercy, the God who saves.
I shall not fear the dark of night, nor the arrow that flies by day.
He will release me from the nets of all my foes. He will protect me from their wicked hands.
Secure.
Blessed be the Lord,
blessed be the Lord,
the God of mercy, the God who saves.
I shall not fear
the dark of night, nor the arrow that flies by day. I need not shrink before the terrors of the night, nor stand alone before the light of day. No harm shall come to me, no arrow strike me down,
no evil settle in my soul.
Blessed be the Lord,
blessed be the Lord,
the God of mercy, the God who saves.
I shall not fear,
I shall not fear
the dark of night,
the dark of night,
nor the arrow that flies by day.
Although a thousand strong have fallen at my side, I'll not be shaken with the Lord at hand. His faithful love is all the armor that I need to wage my battle with the foe.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of mercy, the God who saves. I shall not fear the dark of night, nor the arrow that flies by day.